All right, good afternoon, and glad everybody's here. Before I get going, I want to express my condolences to the Hall family on the passing of Don Hall Sr. He was a true Kansas City icon who did so much for the city. He leaves a tremendous legacy and will be greatly missed. For the Chiefs, it's been a great start to the season. Obviously, we're excited to be coming out of the bye week at 5-0. We've certainly experienced some adversity with the injuries that we've had, and want to compliment the guys who've come in and stepped up in those positions. I think it's a real credit to both Andy Reid and Brett Veach with the job that they've done of taking the next man up and putting him in a position to succeed. With that, I'm happy to open it up to questions.
Clark, I asked Andy this when Kareem first came back, but I wanted to get your thoughts on it as well. When, as you recall, when that video came out a few years ago, the Chiefs moved quickly to release him. How do you reconcile that with bringing him back now?
Yeah, well, going back 6 years ago, we were obviously very disappointed by the actions that we saw in that video and how he handled it afterwards. As we talked about it as an organization here a few weeks ago, both Brett and Andy expressed to me that they felt confident that he had matured from that, that he had learned from the mistake, gotten the help that he had needed, and as a result, we felt comfortable in bringing him back.
Have you talked to him yet? I mean, he was up here with us. He hadn't spoken to you yet. Have you spoken with him?
I have. He expressed to me his gratitude for being back here. He knows it's a really good fit for him from a career standpoint, knows that he left here under some difficult circumstances and is very glad to be back and getting to play for our great fans.
Quick question as it relates to Tom Brady and his ownership that you all approved of. I know going to the finance, you all approved it unanimously. Imagine they did it so yesterday. Was there ever any thought process to making sure, I mean, I know the NFL has put restrictions on his broadcasting, but having to choose between one or the other, because it seems like it's going to hamper what he does for Fox, but it also seems somewhat unfair as a literally an owner in the NFL calling games, especially division opponents and stuff.
Well, we certainly talked about the subject of him being an owner as well as a broadcaster, and the commissioner, after consulting with many owners, decided that the right step to take was to limit his participation in the production meetings, and that was enough to get everybody comfortable with the dual roles. So it did pass unanimously everybody yesterday, so I think everybody felt very comfortable with that.
Is there another quarterback you could envision one day being an owner in this league?
I'm sure he won't be the last.
Clark, you led the committee to allow private equity investment teams. My understanding is that's not a route you guys are pursuing. Just wondering why is it not, particularly as you outline stadium investment potentially being one of the benefits of that?
Yeah, well, every organization and the families who are involved are going to make their own decisions, and there are a lot of things that play into a decision to sell a stake in the team, whether you're selling it to private equity or selling it to another individual. And we've talked about it as a family, and everybody is very excited about the Chiefs and what we're doing on the field and the opportunities that we have in front of us, and we just don't feel it's the right time to sell a stake in the team.
So has any of the other ownership groups started down that road with that at this point yet? And I know there's certain limitations on what private equity companies can get involved in.
Yeah.
What's the process going to be?
Yeah, so it's a very compressed time frame with the league just approving it at the end of August and the paperwork literally being finalized over the last several weeks. My understanding is that there are several teams that are pursuing transactions. One or two of those might close before year end, but I would expect that there'll be many others that will close next year and in the years to come.
Clark, what are your latest thoughts, or what can you share about the timeline of your decision making on the stadium situation?
So for the last 3 months or so, since I had a chance to visit with y'all at training camp, we've been working on creating some options, not only for the stadium, but also for potentially a new training facility. We've been looking at a lot of sites on both the Kansas and Missouri sides, as well as talking to the political leaders in Missouri about perhaps renovating Arrowhead again. We're not at the end of that process at all. We continue to have good conversations, and we're hopeful that by the spring we'll have some direction. I certainly don't expect to have anything finalized by that point, but I'd like to know, you know, the direction that we're headed in that time frame.
I know you guys have outlined a timeline, not a deadline, in training camp, that potentially the end of the year is saying that it's more likely to be a little bit later than that.
Yeah, I would just reiterate what I said at training camp, which is it's very hard for to put a timeline on a stadium process. And so we want to move as quickly as we can. The real deadline that we have is in February of 2031, when our lease runs out here at GEHA Field at Arrowhead. And there's a lot of work that we'll need to go into, either renovating the stadium or building a new one. So we do feel like we need to work as expeditiously as possible.
Clark, I know some of it's self-evident, but I wonder what the three, four things you might point to would be that are what takes so long to make this process thorough and get where you want to get.
Probably the most difficult thing is there are a lot of stakeholders when you're involved in a stadium process. You've got the local city, the county, the state that all have to be part of those conversations. Obviously, there's a lot of work on our side in terms of, you know, figuring out what the right opportunity is for us economically. We also are very cognizant of making sure that we keep the community and our fans in mind. We want to make sure that where we end up will work for many generations of Chiefs fans.
Darren?
Clark, obviously, I believe Arrowhead is going to be used as a polling location in a few weeks, but on the political side, Harrison Butker has created a PAC. Are you fine with your players being involved politically as they are like that?
One of the things I talk to the players about every year at training camp is using their platform to make a difference. Obviously, we have players on both sides of the political spectrum, on both sides of whichever controversial issue you want to bring up. And so I'm not at all concerned when our players use their platform to try to make a difference for what they believe in.
Clark, back to the stadium. The state of Kansas, they did the work with the Star Bonds. That deadline is going to be July 1 or whatever. What do you need to have happen in the state of Missouri through all the levels, city, county, whatever? There's not going to be anything on the ballot this November. Do you anticipate, I guess, that if something gets done in Missouri, it won't be a ballot issue at this point? It's going to have to be another vehicle to get that done?
I think there are a lot of avenues that we could pursue with Missouri on financing for a renovation of GEHA Field at Arrowhead. The effort that failed earlier this year had a couple of stakeholders, with the state being part of it, as well as the county. The city historically has also had a small involvement with the stadium. So I would anticipate that it would be a combination of all three of those. Certainly something that has slowed us down a little bit is the election coming up here in 3 weeks. We're going to have a change in the governor of the state. And so once we get past that, we think that'll really open up the opportunity for us to have more constructive conversations.
From the outside looking in, it looks like, I know there's complicated parts to this, but it looks like Kansas did a whole bunch of work for this, and it looks easier to maybe go do that. Is it not easier just to take that? Is it worth something more to work harder on this side of the state line?
Well, we're not looking for what's easiest. We're looking for the right opportunity. And we're grateful for the work that was done on the Kansas side that opens that up as an opportunity.
We'll go last to Nick and then Nate. Go ahead, Nick.
Clark, for you, from talking to Andy in the airport in Philadelphia 11 years ago to where you are now, do you feel like you guys have been able to build everything that you envisioned culture-wise when you were talking to him?
Yeah, I mean, I think there's argument that we've maybe exceeded my expectations. You know, certainly I envisioned building a team that could consistently compete for championships, and obviously Andy and Brett and their coaching staff and football operations team have done an unbelievable job of that. But you mentioned the culture, and I think that's one of the things that's so special about this team is the culture. Andy Reid gets a lot of credit for having established that culture, but we wouldn't have what we have both on the field and off without the players and the player leadership specifically. Patrick, Travis, Chris Jones, those veteran players do a tremendous job of helping perpetuate the culture that Andy established when he came here 11 plus years ago.
Nate? Clark, you mentioned the possibility of obviously different locations on both sides. Can you share what some of those locations might be on each side of the border? And I guess how important is it that the stadium and the practice facility be sort of tied together instead of maybe, I know Mark has said at some point one might be in one location and the stadium might be in another.
Yeah, it wouldn't be helpful to the process for me to mention specific sites other than obviously, here at the Truman Sports Complex, which is an obvious one. In regards to your second question, the practice facility and the stadium don't have to be next to each other going forward. And on the Missouri side, that's something that we're contemplating is perhaps another location in Missouri for a training facility.
Could they both be in the same state though, or can you envision one in one and one in the other?
I think really everything's on the table in that regard. There's some logic to having them in the same state, but I don't think they have to be.
Can you build a bigger interview room than this?
We're going to build a lot of things that are bigger, for sure.
All right, thanks. Yeah.